lose love, then I move on, never knowing what it feel like. Short days, long nights, by the phone, no call. Need a clear mind, cause I've been blind, got me going down that road. Heart made of stone, far away from home, black woman, you cold. Every problem that you ever had with another man, I gotta face. Started off on thin ice, I'm still here, but I can't stay. Slow sink, can't breathe, no remorse, don't think. Listen to your friend, get another man for a minute, then repeat. Queen, you deserve the title, but she rejects what I give. Why she nursed the wounds by them, tried them, didn't work. Got impossible standards, nothing I'ma do's gon' work. Diary.
Now, jealousy has a, there can be little bits of jealousy, and then jealousy can get really big. So you can have, I would say small is like seeing a comment on your partner's page on Facebook or something, and you're like, why did this person say this? And then a big thing on Facebook would be making a whole fake profile of your partner just to catch other people. Good example.
It is a good example.
It is. And so here's the thing about jealousy that makes it unhealthy. We are all human beings. We will all feel jealousy at one point or another. However, it's how you and your partner handle it that determines whether your relationship is healthy or unhealthy. If you have the respect and trust with the ability to communicate and listen, then jealousy is actually something that at times can be a healthy thing. You know, you realize that your partner is attractive and interesting and other people like them, and you remember all of the things that made the butterflies happen in the first place. But you know that your partner is monogamous and trustworthy and would never do anything about it, then it's a reminder of how great a person you picked. However, if there's ever a feeling of distrust or lack of respect, or fear of commitment that's involved, then jealousy can turn into something that is incredibly unhealthy, that you can't communicate about, and leads to that can lead to issues of power and control, it can lead to manipulation, it can lead to things that are put out in the digital world that can't be taken away. That's when things like pictures get put up, or videos, and can lead to really dangerous situations.
I don't want to talk about it, but I think it should be said by you two, just the fact that jealousy has this positive, like, connotation in relationships, and I don't know, it just...
Oh, I see what you're saying, some people glamorize it, has to be involved.
Like, because he's upset that this guy commented on my picture, it shows that he loves me. I think you should just go a little bit into that, maybe.
Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah, so oftentimes if we don't have our own self-respect, our own self-love, our own self-understanding of who we are, we look to other people to give it to us, right? And that often happens in romantic relationships. And so we look at jealousy as a validation of their feelings for us.
In our importance.
That's right. And although a small amount sparks a reminder of our initial attraction, might be something that spices up a relationship. Anything more than that small amount that you need to feel secure, that's definitely a sign of something that we need to look at within ourselves. Why are we feeling that we need our partner to feel jealous in order to feel important or attractive? We should feel important and attractive every day in our relationship.
Sometimes jealousy is directly related to power control, because they'll be jealous because they want to control.
And then that's how the control comes out. Yes.
Possessiveness.
Yes. Okay. And it also goes down to the obsession part. So let's just roll right on through.
Well, first, another thing I wanted to say about jealousy is that a lot of people justify their jealousy by saying, I'm not jealous of my boyfriend, or I don't distrust my boyfriend, I distrust everybody else.
Right. Yeah.
No.
Sure, you can do
even
that,
if you didn't trust anybody else, if you don't trust your partner enough to know that they're not going to act on those impulses of other people that you distrust, then there's some sort of disconnect here. And this is something that I've talked to a lot of people about. They'll say, no, it's not them, it's not them, it's that girl. It's that girl over there, she's going to take him away. And it's like, no. If he really cares about you as much as you believe that he does, or maybe you don't believe that he does.
Right. Then it's about your relationship with him.
Exactly.
It's not about his relationship with anyone else.
I don't know how to move forward, where I went wrong. Wish I could live with no fear, I'm so down and out. I'll keep it moving and try to get out.